Ray Cooper, former Virgin Records America co-president with Ashley Newton, given credit for the worldwide success of the Spice Girls, died on Saturday, July 28, in Guildford, Surrey, England. He was 69 and had been suffering from a rare neurological condition, progressive primary aphasia PPA, which also affected Monty Python's Terry Jones, causing loss of speech. Virgin Records founder Richard Branson called him an extraordinary, delightful individual and an incredible talent. Virgin Records would never have grown into the music force it became without him. Cooper was originally named to the post with Newton in September 1997, after the departure of Virgin President CEO Phil Quartararo, who left to join Warner Brothers Records. The two came over from Virgin UK, which they led to the third largest music group in Britain. Cooper was one of the first of a wave of UK execs who made their way to the US, including current music group chiefs for Universal Music Group Lucian Grange, Sony Music Rob Stringer, and Warner Music Group Max Lusada. He started his career in 1972 as a sales rep for Nat Joseph's Eclectic Transatlantic Records, rising through the ranks to become sales manager. In the late 70s, he worked for Ian Rolfini's Anchor Records and then Don Arden's Jet Records, helping break Electric Light Orchestra worldwide. Cooper became a sales director for Island Records in 1980, then marketing director, responsible for a world-class roster that included Bob Marley, U2 and Frankie Goes to Hollywood. It was there he first met and formed a successful working partnership with the label's A&R director Ashley Newton. Capital Music Group president Ashley Newton praised his longtime partner Ian the wild good fortune to be both a close friend and business ally with this vibrant, fearless, talented and kind man. Together, across several decades and labels, Ray and I were blessed to be consistently in the orbit of immensely important music, but like everyone around him, I was forever surrendering to his ridiculously sharp and eccentric sense of humor. We literally laughed through the ages and I will miss him more than words can express. Cooper and Newton launched Circa Records in the UK in 1986, home to the likes of Massive Attack and Nene Cherry, before the indie label was acquired by Virgin in 1995, adding the two founders as co-managing directors of the UK company, where they famously broke the Spice Girls, Daft Punk and The Verve. The two were subsequently named co-presidents of the US label by then Emmy recorded music head Ken Berry, where they joined his wife Nancy Berry as the ruling troika. With Newton in charge of A&R and Cooper handling marketing, the team took the label to new heights, with acts like Janet Jackson, Smashing Pumpkins, Lenny Kravitz, N.E.R.D., The Rolling Stones and David Bowie. Cooper remained at Virgin Records until 2002. When he formed his own Venice, California-based management/consulting company Zama Media Management and worked for the environmental organization Future Forests. He was also part of a team that helped bring the Chinese group The 12 Girls Band to North America in 2004, and found and construct a company that linked artists with Milan designers to develop fashion lines for clients such as Massive Attack. Having worked in the industry for nearly 3 decades, I wanted to continue to learn and evolve, Cooper told Billboard in 2004. So the idea of representing talent and creative ideas across environment, music, fashion, new technology, art, film and TV seemed to have a strong thread to it. All of those areas tend to coexist together in media and marketing and ultimately, hopefully, to the consumer. Said veteran publicist Lord Cohen Gooden, who worked with Ray at Virgin. He was a warm-hearted, whip-smart gentleman with a great sense of humor, who truly cared about the people who worked for him. When I first went indie, he helped connect me with several of my first clients. I'm very grateful to have had the opportunity to learn from him. Ray is survived by partner Philippa, sister Pam, daughter Becky, grandsons James and Jack, stepdaughter Liana and son Christopher Robin. Celebrations marking what would have been his 17th birthday in December will be held in London and Los Angeles, where he had worked since 1998. Tributes from the music industry poured in following news of his death. I am saddened to hear of the passing of Ray Cooper. Ray's guidance, support, creative and marketing ideas from the very beginning were invaluable to the success of the Spice Girls. It was obvious to all who spent time with Ray that he was not only a favorite to his team, but also a favorite to artists and their managers. Ray had passion for life and his work and it showed in his many successes. I will be forever grateful to Ray Cooper. Ray, rest in peace. Victoria Beckham and U2 were signed to Island Records in 1980. Every label but Island had passed. It was,